Slippery Rock University, home of rock football. A small state school tucked away into the foothills of western Pennsylvania lays claim to a story that few other Division II programs can hold true. Dubbed America's favorite small college football team, the Rock is preparing for its now third appearance on the nation's largest stage, the Big House. On September 29th, 1979, the Rock, led by head coach Bob DiSpirito, made their Big House debut, setting the Division II national attendance record with 61,143 screaming fans, a record that holds to this day. After an embarrassing 45-14 loss to Shippensburg and a close loss in 1981 to Wayne State, a third opportunity to enter the Big House is the ultimate shot at redemption. It's a chance for Rock football to make its mark on history.
Now, it's the university's 125th anniversary. You know that, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. It's the 35th anniversary since the Rock played in the Big House and set the Division II attendance record. It's the 35th year going back. So I thought what we would do is we would really have a throwback uniform.
Let's be honest, Division II is great, but the perks of being a big-ticket program just aren't always here. After over a year of planning and design, meetings and deliberation, Coach George Mihalik revealed a full uniform, custom-tailored by Adidas, just for this team, just for this game. The excitement in the room was palpable. The smiles and cheers are evidence enough of just how much this means to each and every player. The legacy of this program has become personal with each player's shot to enter the Big House battle. Leaders made speeches, news outlets took notice, and the campus was set ablaze with anticipation of what this game could mean. It's been 33 years since Rock football has played at the University of Michigan. With all the commotion surrounding this week, distractions are a given, but now more than ever, it is important that the Rock stay focused on the task at hand. Beat Mercyhurst.
Hey, look, this is great, under the lights.
Yesterday we locking on. My bad. I had y'all thinking y'all was gonna go switch it. Okay. I thought we would switch. I messed that up in the meeting, so that's on me. So we'll go here. We got the two. He coming over. He gonna get his three. This end on how the other two corner. You got that tight end on the backside. A lot of times on that third down, they will be in 21P. And go on third down and run some stuff. So, shit, if they come out in that, they probably doing a sprint out. They like the flat, not the flat seven, but the snag seven and stuff still over here in this part of the field. But they will run some sprint out there. So lock that on backside. Hey, if that guy's his hinge and blocks right
40
here.
40 is.
Bro, this is 12 personnel. Again, we gotta take this off here.
Having started the season 5-0, the Rock is entering this week fresh off a 48-26 loss to rival California University of Pennsylvania. Countless hours of preparation behind the scenes go into every game, but this week is different. This week has been 35 years in the making. This week may not come again for another 35 years. In the words of the great Vince Lombardi, football is like life. It requires perseverance, self-denial, hard work, sacrifice, dedication, and ultimately, a respect for authority.
They're a pound-out, grind-out type of football team, Mercyhurst. I'm telling you that. They're a pound-out, grind-out type of football. They're killing them this week in practice, okay? They're that type of football team. But this is what I need to say. That's the mentality of their football team. That's their mentality. That's their offensive makeup, the way their football players are supposed to go. The football plays in that offense. But let me tell you something. They might have the X and O's, but they don't have the Jimmy and Joe's. What I'm trying to say, their players are not that good. They're not. They're not that good. They try to be a physical football team, but they don't have as good as a football team they've had in years past with their personnel, the guys behind it, to make that stuff work. That offensive line is very young, okay? They try to be physical. They try to create that balance mentality. They try to create that attitude, but they're just not that good. They're not that good, that offensive line. They're not. That's as pure and simple as you can say it, okay? That's as pure and simple as you can say it. The receivers are not, they have one guy, they might have maybe one and a half, but it's not like California's receivers. The tailback is damn good. He's the focal point. The quarterback, Dukes, is damn good. But the thing about a Florida kid, if you hit him, and you hit him, and you hit him, it's going to take a little bit of time, but we'll get him to quit. We'll get him to quit. They're a pound out, grind out type of football team. They're killing him this week in practice. That's the mentality of their football team. They might have the X and O's, but they don't have the Jimmy and Joe's. Their players are not that good. They're not. They're not that good. Their players are not that good. They might have the X and O's, but they don't have the Jimmy and Joe's.
Yeah, because it was an embarrassment.
Yeah,
it was embarrassing, yeah. And, but then you remember, the excitement coming out of that tunnel and hearing the crowd's response that it's nothing like our players have ever heard before.
The noise that crowd could generate and the atmosphere that crowd generated would be nothing like your players have experienced before. Any concerns about that? Either way, if I'm a coaching
matter of fact, I shared that with the team last night. I said, you better focus on the signals because nobody's going to holler out to you what you might not have seen or, an adjustment. So the noise level will be unlike anything you've experienced. And, you know, at our practices, we typically play music, so there is a loud noise factor at our practices, and you know, probably even turn that up a little more tonight and tomorrow. Yeah, the quarterback's thrown for over 1,000 yards and 10 touchdowns, and he wasn't the starter at the beginning of the season. So I'm not exactly sure. I know he started the last two games. I don't know if he started the last three, but those are impressive numbers for a guy who didn't start at least the first two games. There's still a philosophy. They still are going to establish that run game. Because against Gannon, they had 182 yards rushing, so that's that's nothing to overlook. And once they get that running game going, their play-action passing game is very devastating if they get that running game going.
Thanks for all your support. All right. Hey, to all you students out there, all right? To all the students, if you're not going to Michigan, what the hell's the matter with you? You have a chance to be part of history. You have a chance to be part of the largest crowd to ever watch a Division II football game. We're going to break that record, but we need you up there. So whatever your plans are, if it doesn't include Michigan, cancel them. Our team, you know, we're excited to play this game, and there's a lot of hoopla and a lot of excitement surrounding this event. And the university's done a great job promoting this game. Now it's up to us to take advantage of this opportunity. I can guarantee you one thing. This football team, you know, we have a new uniform for Michigan. It's going to be worn one time only, that jersey in the big house. Hopefully you've seen it online. Hopefully you'll see it in person. Bottom line, this team's going up. We have one mission. One mission. And that's to win that game in a big house. Yeah. So be there and be part of it. And go Rock. Go Rock.
We love the school support, man. Everybody coming out, showing us love, man. We're trying to set a new record for attendance. Go out here and just do what we got to do,
come
man.
Come out and support the Rock, you know, boys, Rock man. Boys. We get this dub up, Michigan. I mean, yeah. We're all about doves.
No mercy for the hearse. Let them know that.
No mercy for the hearse. Like you said, hearse no week. Mercy for the hearse.
Coach K. Coach, come on in.
Probably wonder what an old fart's doing in here. I don't know the X's and O's that you guys know. But I tell you, that bus ride Saturday must have gnawed at your guts. If you think that was bad, don't lose at Michigan. It'll be 10 times worse. Don't lose at Michigan. That'll be 10 times worse. You're gonna remember it the rest of your life. Michigan. You're gonna remember it the rest of your life.
I've been in this game for years. It made me an animal. It made me an animal. It made me. I've been in this game for years. It made me an animal. It made me an animal. I've been in this game for years. It may be an animal. It may be an animal. It may be an animal. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
You've got the big house. You got it all going for you guys. Don't let it run loose on you. You won't forget the big house. Don't let it run loose on you. Don't let it run loose on you.
Okay, let's gather in tight. Let's go. Okay, let's take some time. Mentally picture what you got to get done. See yourself making plays in the big house. All three phases, special teams, got to win the field position battle. Big plays, defense, sacks, create interceptions, big hits. I want excitement, I want enthusiasm. Offense. Moving the football, putting in the end zone, celebrate in the end zone. I want to see some excitement, some passion. See the brotherhood celebrating. See this that will be embedded in your mind as a lifetime memory. It'll be a lifetime memory that we all will share. In the future, you're going to come back, we'll all get together. We're going to talk about this game. We're going to talk about it. We're going to remember it. As I said, when your son, your daughter, your grandchild looks at that jersey on the wall and says, "Tell me about that game." You say, "I was the only one to ever wear that jersey." "Well, tell me about that game, Dad. Tell me, Grandpa, did you win?" Think of that, fellas. You know what you want that answer to be. Yes. Yes. So, you know, we know that's in the back of our mind. Relax today. Enjoy the trip. The brotherhood's on its way. The brotherhood's on the way. Big house, here we come. Here we come. We're looking for number 6. Grab on. All right, good job, fellas. All right. Man, I can't wait. I wouldn't want to be any other place but with you guys. It's where I want to be. Rock pride on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Rock pride.
Hey, fellas. President Norton and her husband Henry, come on up to wish us well.
Hey, no. We're applauding you. You are the right team in the right place at the right time, because this is about tradition. This is about tradition of not just the football team, but about Slippery Rock University. People know this institution as one of academic excellence, and they're gonna see what you do on the field, not just in Michigan, but around the country, because you will make the news, and people will know that Slippery Rock University should be not only at the top of their list academically, but at the top of their list as a football team. So my thanks to you for being here today. My thanks to you for getting up your energy level to the point that you will hold nothing back to win this game. It's our time. It's your time. Go Rock!
This trip is the culmination of 35 years of frustration for Rock football head coach, George Mihalik. This is about more than just a game. It's a homecoming of sorts. A chance to escort his players back into a place rich with history that he helped create. This is Mihalik's one last chance to add to the legacy of America's favorite small college football team. A win in the Big House would break down the wall between what was and what can be. It means a chance to put Slippery Rock University on the map.
Rock boys, we made it to the Big House.
Can I get my phone now?
Hey, 1 o'clock tomorrow. Be there. Game time.
Breath. 109,901. The number of fans who can be seated in the Big House, the nation's largest football stadium. 46,800. The number of square feet of turf that covers this historic field. 3,600. The number of seconds of game time that will be played. 263. The number of miles traveled for this very moment, right here. Zero. The number of times this team, with these players, will get to play together in this stadium again.
Ready to go. Okay. Very first thing, guys. Okay, he wanted me to read a couple comments from the coach at Mercyhurst that was in the paper here. Basically, his quote was this: "We're coming off two huge wins, so we have a lot of confidence going this game. The biggest thing that we are all about is being a physical football team. Something's going to give on Saturday." Okay? So, you know, the biggest thing, guys, and the message, okay, we talk about it. And I just like to make you guys understand something. You know, Coach Mihalik put this whole thing together. I remember going to Michigan 3 years ago. They had us back. And his big thing is they played a long time ago. And he wanted to bring this team back to the big house. Okay? And let's look at the things he has done to get this thing jump-started and look at the things that is going on for this whole trip. I mean, you got those jerseys you like. You got those helmets. Okay, you got all that nice stuff. Awesome hotel we're staying at. The food's been unbelievable. Okay? We put all that stuff together for you guys. Coach Mihalik did. Not the coaching staff, he put all this stuff together. He took funds that he didn't have, put it together so you guys can have the trip of a lifetime, a first-class program, and make this a great, great experience for you guys. Okay, so what I kind of thought, okay, and I talked to the captains about this, and this is a big-time thing, and we gotta do this, guys. When we kick Mercyhurst's ass tomorrow, okay, talk to Papa Steele about it, we are going to present a game ball, the captains, to Coach Mihalik. Okay, I think that would be a thing that we should do. We're going to present that game ball to Coach Mihalik because this game, you know what kind of mood he's been in all week. This trip, this game means a lot to him because right now, guys, we're 0-2 in the big house, and that's going to end tomorrow at 1 o'clock. It's going to end tomorrow at 1 o'clock. You know, if you look at this game, okay, you got two teams going a lot of different directions. Okay, you give Mercyhurst credit because we know they're a team that has a lot of pride. It is a home game for us, but the way I look at it, we're really playing at a neutral site. That's not our home. That's not our stadium. That's not Mihalik Thompson Stadium. Okay, we play at 1 o'clock tomorrow, guys. Someone is going to take that field over, and it's going to be their field around 4 o'clock, 4:30. It's going to be their field. Someone's field, and it's going to be our field. You guys understand that? Right now, we are the home team, but that's not our stadium. We know that. But at 4 o'clock, 4:30, 5 o'clock, whenever that game ends, okay, someone's taking ownership of that place. Someone's going to take ownership of that place. Some guy's got to sell out. Some guy's got to sell out. If you're not getting many snaps tomorrow, okay, be that team player. If you're not getting the ball as a receiver, so what? Do the other things you need to. Let's just, guys, swallow our pride tomorrow. Swallow our pride. Let's be a team. Let's be a team, whatever it takes to win that game. But I want to go in there. The staff wants to go in there. And I want to punish this opponent. I want to punish those guys. I know you guys do too. They don't know what they're getting themselves into. We're coming out with a purpose. We're going to execute. We're going to be disciplined. And you know what? That team won't quit. But we're going to make them quit. We are going to make them quit. It's about the team effort. Do your job. Play your ass off. Be relentless on that football field, guys. Be relentless. Get ready to go. Tonight, focus. Tomorrow, when you get up, you're not saying, boy, that helmet looks good. Boy, that damn, even though you look damn good, not gonna take that away from you. But you know what I'm saying? That's not going to win you the games. What wins you football games, guys, is confidence and right here, heart, and playing your ass off. Let's get on them early. Let's go execute. There's not a better offense than they're going to see than our offense on Saturday. Special teams-wise, I love seeing you guys run down, hit somebody in the mouth. I mean that, okay? I want to see someone say, who's making this big hit? Who's going to spark this thing? Guys, we're in this together. If the defense does something bad, we know the offense is going to make a play for us. If you guys turn over the ball, we're going to stop them for you. We are in this all together. And that's the approach you need to take. Don't worry about those other things. Let's focus. You guys understand? Let's focus what we need to do. Okay, let's get it done. Okay.
That tight end, know where he is at all times. That tight end screen, all that stuff. They run a reverse. You know you're going to get them running a reverse and throwing a reverse pass out of that. Just stay deep. They're going to try to do some token stuff that they're not used to doing, guys. And gimmick plays, we just don't want to give them anything. Okay? I already told Coach Mihalik, I think he's going to do it. We're gonna defer to the second half this time. I want our defense to get an opportunity to go out there because we're gonna shut their ass down. You guys understand that? I'm gonna tell you something, guys. Okay, we're going out there for a purpose. We don't give a shit right now about anything about all this other stuff. We know what we gotta do. What we gotta do is no different. In any other game, we already prepared ourselves where we need to do. You need to go out there and smack them in the mouth, get them in that old school phone booth, and hit them. Hit them hard, get downhill, challenge them. Don't be sitting back waiting for anything. Snug your guys. We're coming at these guys. We're coming at these guys. We are playing slip rock defense, relentless football. From beginning to the end, 60 minutes of hell, guys. Relentless. Let's go and get in here.
Let's go, man. Let's go, y'all. All or nothing, baby.
Yeah, relentless on three. 1, 2, 3.
Honestly, I really don't care about playing in the big house. I'm not excited for this game. I'm just excited to win.
Playing in the big house, personally, I think it's gonna be awesome. I haven't really played in front of that many fans. Personally, I'm a senior. So if we lose this game, it's probably going to be, you know, one of my last games where it means something. You know, focus up and go from there.
Excited to win.
What can you say at this point, huh? What else can you say? It's here.
It's here. I want you right now, look around. Look around at these eyes. Look around at your brothers. Look around. That moment is frozen in history. You'll remember this for the rest of your life. We're going to remember this game for the rest of our lives. And it's going to be a game that we're going to go out there right now, and we're going to take this football game, and we're coming back in here 6-0, baby. Woo! We're coming back in with the win. Let's go.
Get it done. Oh. Get it done. Oh. Get it done. Oh. 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 Let's get it.
We are set to go here as quite a sight on the field right now. You have the University of Michigan Go Blue Band on the field welcoming the Rock football team on as they make their way through the Slippery Rock University Band. And as you look at the field as we're looking at it, standing here looking over the 50-yard line, the Rock band is off to our right. You have the Mercyhurst band off to the left. They're going to welcome their team out. Just a lot of pageantry. This is a great college football atmosphere.
Well, let's be honest. One thing that really jumped out of the stat sheet at me is so far in this year, Mercyhurst only has 6 sacks on the year against opposing quarterbacks. Meanwhile, Slippery Rock has only given up 6. So Mercyhurst is not a team that is really built to get after the quarterback. All 6 sacks are between 6 different individuals, so they don't really have a guy who's out there who's, you know, your real threat. You know, they don't have a Marcus Martin, let's put it that way, a guy who's consistently going to get after the quarterback. So one thing that you do like, if it gets to the point where Slippery Rock has to air it out a little bit today and start slinging it, is that it doesn't seem like pressure from Mercyhurst is going to be too much of an issue.
And back deep as we get set for the kickoff, going to be Julian Durden and Drew Scales, the speed backs, getting ready to receive the kickoff here today. So we're just about set to go. The Big House battle. Back out, it will be Jared Buck leading and engineering. And right now we bring out Shamar Green and Teddy Blakeman into the backfield. And it's a play action. Buck looking downfield. He throws long, has a man breaking under the ball. Caught for a touchdown. Slippery Rock University. Pay dirt. It's Leroy McClain with the 52-yard touchdown pass from Jared Buck following the penalty.
Way to take advantage of the penalty.
52 yards. And the Rock is up 6-0. Here's Wani. Mike Wanoskis on for the extra point. And it's up through the uprights and good. And just like that, Slippery Rock University at the 13-24 mark of the first quarter have taken the lead.
So fake that inside zone read and hit Harrell on a quick out.
Here's a handoff. It's Blakeman in for the touchdown.
There's a flag.
And here's a flag. And maybe a hit after the play there. Boy, taking a shot was Malik Ford Jr. playing the slot. And Jared Buck already signaling it was a hold on the Rock. This is going to end up being just about a 28-yard attempt for Wani. Mike Wanoskis under the hold of Jared Buck. Here's the snap. It looks good. The kick is up. It's high enough, and it's good. And that puts 3 more up on the board for the Rock. They take a 10-0 lead at the 4:52 mark of the first quarter. It's the big battle, the Big House battle.
SRU! 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 SRU!
Here comes Mercyhurst looking to convert a third down here with the Brown Dukes in the backfield alone. Boylan will go under center. Long count. Now he'll hand it off. Brown Dukes, and he's hit in the backfield. Dropped shy of the first down. Derek Fulmar was first in. Austin Mealy was there along with Cody Conway. And they are going to go for it. It'll be 4th and 4, Mercyhurst from the 21. Boylan in the shotgun, sends a man in motion. Here's the snap. He looks downfield. He throws downfield to a wide open Brandon Brown Dukes, and he's in for the touchdown. They saw something they liked. They got the matchup they wanted, and it's a touchdown pass to Brown Dukes. Here's the hold by Colin Kimball, and the kick is good. Here we go with the kickoff. And it's going to be a short one taken by Drew Scales at about the 11. And he's got some blocking, and he breaks a hole across the 30. He's across the 40, knocked out of bounds. And let's see where they spot it, 41-yard line. So that'll be a return of 30 yards.
Hey, you got to go. We
Our play action is going to be choice against them. We just got to go and control the line of scrimmage, all right? Get some runs in and get them. They're trying to commit a lot of guys, all right? They're committing a lot of guys to the run. We can crease them, and when we crease them, it's going to be a big play. All right, then we come back with some play action. Come on, let's go.
Jamar Green in the backfield, and he's alongside Jared Buck. Now they send Scales in motion again, this time from the pistol. Buck play actions, and he throws downfield, has a man breaking. It's going to be thrown too long in and out of the hands of the defender, and that one was just overthrown. His intended receiver that time was number 88, Tyshawn Tucker, and an I formation look. Now they pass. Boylan hits his tight end, Miller, and he's got a first down again. That tight end has been an issue for the Rock defense. He gets it out to the 47-yard line. Rock going to get it back. Here's Drew Scales at his 16. And here's the kick, and it's a low kick. And good pressure coming from Mercyhurst. They miss him, though. He's got the ball coming to the near side. One man to beat to get to the outside. He's got it to the 25. Oh, and they get a shoestring. And he springs across the 30 to the 32. Literally, the speed Drew Scales had when the shoestring was caught launched him 5 yards in the air. Play action. Jared Buck across the middle. Hits his man for a first down inside the five. Ball is away from Leroy McClay, but they're going to say he's down.
The back judge threw in the beanbag saying it was a fumble. The umpire here on the near side called him down.
Jamar Green, he's in the backfield, and look, here's Brett Crenshaw in the backfield now, and Jamar Dutrell joins him, and it's Dutrell. He'll take the handoff. He's got running room for the touchdown. They put Jamar Dutrell in the backfield. That's something we really haven't seen since last year, maybe the year before, but it is in for the touchdown. As number 7, Jamar Dutrell goes in from 4 yards out. 16-7 now, Wani on for the extra point, and Jared Buck with the hold, and it's blocked. The extra point is blocked, but the Rock leads it still 16-7. Big third down here, it's 3rd and 6. Now they're going to double tight end stack on the far side and bring a receiver to the near side in motion, and that is Williams. And they're looking his way. Boylan wants him. Now he dumps it across the middle, and he's got a man wide open, and he's on his way for the touchdown. That is number 81, Stephen Yarborough, and he gets it. So here we go. 2nd and 9. Everybody back on the field and set. Shamar Green in the backfield.
Melvin German has man coverage up top.
And here's the snap. Buck, he's looking that way. He wants it. He throws long, has a man wide open. It's a Rock touchdown. Nick Carter, 41 yards. They answer a 41-yard touchdown from Mercyhurst with one of their own.
That is twice now. The post down the middle of the field has been wide open. The first time by, I believe, Leroy McClain on the first touchdown. This one by Nick Davis. Again, if you're set up in that slot, get downfield, you run right at the safety, you give him a little bit of a head juke, and then you cut towards the middle of the field and get your separation. Twice now they've run it, twice now Jared Buck's put it right on the money. Beautiful, beautiful.
And a great read by number 11, too. I mean, and folks, this is his first game of the year in action. Here's his hold. Mike Wanoskis gets this one through, and it's good. So, The Rock hitting pay dirt. We talked about the touchdown. We got it. Back up by 9 now. 23-14 following the 41-yard touchdown strike from Jared Buck to Nick Carter, and that is the second touchdown pass of the day from Jared Buck. And he boots her away. And up underneath is number 27, that's Drew Robinson. Brings it across the 20, still alive, bounces off the pile, and he's got room to run. He's got two men to beat, but he's not going to get it. Gets it across the 50, though, to the 48. Boy, that one looked like it had danger written all over it. In motion goes Miller, the tight end. Boylan, he's looking that way. Now he throws it across the middle, wide open. He's got Donnie Hall, the fullback, out of the backfield, inside the 15, down to the 13-yard line. That'll be a gain of 20. Well, let's see what happens now. It'll be a 30-yard attempt with 4 seconds to go. The place kicker is Dylan Condis. The holder is Colin Kimball. Here's the snap. It's good. Snap is good. Kick is up. And it is also good from 30 yards out. Condis is good, and that'll end the half. and make it a 23-17 score. So we've got a barn burner here in the Big House.
They already got too much. Let's go. Let's hold it down.
Start, Community. We're giving them stuff. It's mental stuff.
On every single play, they're Mickey Mouse and stuff right there. And we got, okay, you got him. I got him.
Be sharp and just do our job, guys. We're good shape. I'm glad they get the ball because someone's going to punch them in the mouth. Let's go back to basics for Brady.
Okay, because we can get 21 out of there, and now you can play one-on-one running back.
Let's go. Bring it in. Well, make some comments so we can get out there and flex. Go down. Get on the field, go to the right, and flex. All right, fellas, we got 30 minutes. We're winning the ball game. They don't score, we win.
Let's go! Everybody put your heart in his head. Let's go. Play with some prayer. Let's go. Get it down! Get it down! Get it down! Play with some prayer, man. Come on!
Slippery Rock University, experience the difference. Presenting the Battle at the Big House, it's Rock Football, and hey, we're set to go. Second half of action is right underway, and it's Tyler Matuzak with a booming kick deep into the end zone. And Mercyhurst now will be moving right to left with number 27, Drew Robertson, fourth and two. Here's the snap, Emmerich. He looks to fade pass, swings it out to the tight end, Miller. He's got the touchdown.
I mean, I hate to phrase it this way, but at this point, it's almost like the Rock defense is actively trying not to cover tight ends.
Here's the snap, Boylan. Throws it. Touchdown. Duke's alone in the backfield. He'll take the handoff, though, and he's got a huge hole right up over the right tackle. Play action. Boylan. Now he's flushed out of the pocket. Now he throws downfield. He's got a man, and he makes a tremendous catch for a touchdown. Play action, trickery, the end around, and it's going to be a touchdown.
Listen to me. Listen to me.
It'll be a turnover on downs, and Mercyhurst is feeling it right now.
This Slippery Rock defense, all they do is chase the action. They don't wait. They don't stay disciplined. They don't wait and stay in their zones or in their lanes. This is an undisciplined unit that all they want to do is chase the action.
Slippery Rock University. Down now, 45-23.
Yeah, I mean, they have. After, 78 runs against East Stroudsburg, they've completely just abandoned the run almost.
It's almost just like a team that's not confident with the running game right now, and as surprising as that may be. Here's Jared Buck on the keeper. He gets across the 25 to the 26 and is brought down, and that's going to wrap up the game. The clock turns to zero, and Mercyhurst has come away with a dramatic second half comeback and wins it 45-23. We'll be back to recap coming back here in a moment on The Rock Station 97.7.
Hey, at least we look pretty. Hey, I don't want any comments. It's my turn. Like I said, better have some damn thick skin. Quit taking shit off. It's my turn to talk. Like I said, hey, we look pretty. I guess if you're gonna get your ass kicked, at least you wanna look pretty. Over backwards, do everything, get everything we can, and we go out and perform like that. All the way around. All three phases. No one's more pissed off than I am. So we don't need any drama. We don't need any behaviors in here. When you lose, you lose. We got embarrassed. Losing hurts the shit out of me. You know what? If it doesn't hurt the hell out of you, at least fake it. I better not hear a damn word on any bus going home. At some point, you're going to look in the mirror. We're all going to look in the mirror, and we're going to become men. And we're all going to take ownership. We're going to say that we're capable of a hell of a lot better than this. But right now, the rest of the team's on our schedule. Can't wait to play us. So you got to stick together. Remember what this feels like. Because it doesn't have to be this. Doesn't. Let's go. Bring it in. Rock Pride on three. 1, 2, 3.
Rock Pride.
Lance Armstrong quite possibly said it best. Pain is temporary. It can last a minute or an hour, a day or a year, but eventually it will subside and something else will take its place. But if I quit, that lasts forever. That surrender, even the smallest act of giving up, stays with me. So when I want to quit, I ask myself, what would I rather live with? For Rock Football, this is a question every player has to ask themselves today. Is this the end of a line? Or is there more to our story? Slippery Rock went on to finish the season with 4 consecutive wins, outscoring opponents 133-62 along the way. More motivated than ever, the Rock journeyed back to its roots, averaging 231 rushing yards per game, while holding opponents to an average of only 87 yards on the ground. So maybe they didn't win the battle, but this season, Rock football won the war. And looking past the tears, the sleepless nights, the long quiet bus rides home, one can find a story with resilience and determination through and through. The Rock went on to win the Pennsylvania State Athletic Conference Championship and earn their 2nd consecutive berth in the NCAA Division II playoffs. Tucked away in the foothills of Western Pennsylvania, the spirit of America's favorite small college football team lives on. In Slippery Rock.